Also tonight, a special initiative aimed at inspiring young people to explore careers in aviation and STEM-related fields is taking flight. Samantha Spitz has a look at the program from inside Metropolitan State University of Denver's Department of Aviation and Aerospace Science.
In a place designed for learning,
so the plan for today is we're going to part one.
Students from all over the state are getting their chance to fly.
Positive rig, gear up. Being in the program has really gotten me to push myself beyond my limits. They take it pretty seriously.
Sponsored by the Denver chapter of the Tuskegee Airmen, the Mile High Flight program works to increase youth understanding of aviation and aerospace industries while sharing the history of the Tuskegee Airmen, the first black military pilots in the nation's history.
My overall goal really is just to become a pilot, join the airlines, and really get to see more of the world.
Fueling young minds with the resources they need to succeed.
Well, the focus and the foundation of the program is aviation, but it's much, much more than that.
Eric Mosley, a United Airlines captain and son of the late Tuskegee Airman John Mosley, is one of the founding coordinators of the program.
Well, it's a labor of love, but at the end of the day, what we want our students to understand is that through hard work and a good flight plan, that there's really nothing that they can't succeed in if they really put their minds to it.
Former students, now pilots, giving back to the program that gave them their start.
It's like a time capsule a little bit. Just walking down the halls, I can still hear the laughter and just the good times I had with the friends that I made here.
Seeing the successes that our students have had over the years, that pays off in ways that are almost impossible to describe.
Serving as an inspiration for the next generation of aviation students.
Study hard, work hard, and it may be tiring. You may have to write 4 essays on the same day, but in the end, it will all be worth it.
In Denver, Samantha Spitz, 2 Prime News.